to start live streaming and you are looking for solutions on how to set up a live broadcast, then you are most welcome to my channel, Tech Talk Zambia. I am George Mumbi, and in today's video, I'm going to be explaining to you about seven important things that you need to, in order to set up a live broadcast. So there are a couple of ways you can do live streaming. Of course, the easiest and the most simplest way is simply to use a smartphone. And if you want to make it even a bit more professional, you can simply hook up the phone to the computer's webcam through the use of some dedicated softwares, which I'm going to be talking about in my next video. And then from there, it is now just a matter of connecting the feed to streaming softwares like OBS and vMix. And suppose you do not want to use a smartphone and you want to consider some more advanced options, then definitely you need to listen to these seven important items that you need to put in place if you are to start live streaming. Of course, the first one that you need to consider purchasing is a professional camera. And this camera that we are talking about is one that has got either a clean HDMI out or an SDI video output. And if you're just starting out, I would definitely advise you to go for this entry-level camera. This is called the Canon VXHF R800. It's a very good camera, though it's small like this, but you're going to get the best out of this camera. And it's not all that expensive. This camera is within the range of $200. And then the second thing that I want to talk about if you're going to be streaming live is, of course, a computer. So you definitely need a streaming computer. Live streaming requires more of system resources. If you're going to be streaming, definitely you need to have in place a computer which is very fast. That's why I'm saying you need to consider purchasing at least a Core i5 or Core i7 computer. And then the other thing that I want to talk about is a capture card. Now let me put an emphasis on this one. If you check from any computer, most of the ports that you are going to find there, like the display port, the VGA or HDMI, most of those are not for video inputs. Most of those video ports that you see on the computer are for video output. You need to consider getting yourself a capture card. So basically, a capture card works as an interface in between your camera and the computer. Now, not all cameras support the use of a capture card. Cameras like DSLR cameras, most of these do not support the use of a capture card. So basically, what you are looking at is a software that is going to enable you to get a feed from a DSLR camera into the computer. And this software is called SparkleCam. Then that is if you are using a single camera. So let me also talk about the situation where you need to set up a professional live broadcast using more than two cameras. So definitely you need to consider purchasing yourself either a capture card that has got more video inputs, or you go for a video switcher like the one which is here. This is called the Anthem Television Studio HD, and it has got about 8 video input ports. So you can have about 8 cameras connected to this device, and it is now just a matter of selecting which one you want to send to a program output. This switcher costs not more than $1,000, so definitely we are talking about somewhere $995. Then not forgetting sound, definitely you need to consider putting in place some sound equipment. And in my next video, I'm going to be talking about these sound equipment that you need to put in place. You also need to have sufficient lighting. Not forgetting cables. Cables are very important. And of course, some cameras can even be connected wirelessly, but I usually recommend the use of wired connection, depending on the type of interface that your camera has. Some cameras have HDMI video out, or others have SDI. So you need to choose which type of cables you're going to get. Of course, if you're going to go for HDMI cables, you need to put in mind that most of these cables have got what we call distance limitation. So if you just go for an ordinary HDMI cable, definitely you need to consider purchasing either an HDMI splitter or even a repeater so that your signal is going to be boosted. But you can even go for a cable that has got an active repeater built within the cable. So a cable like this one, which is here, it's an HDMI cable, and it has got, as you can see, it has got this active repeater here. So what this does is to boost the signal. So if you go for a FAT HDMI cable that doesn't have this active repeater or even Ethernet belt within it, then definitely you won't have a signal, because the maximum distance you can go for HDMI cable is not more than 5 meters. And the last thing that I wanted to talk about is internet connection. You know that you can't do anything without proper internet connection. And most mistakes that most streamers make is where they get to stream live using Wi-Fi. So if you are going to be streaming live, it's better you consider getting yourself a 4G router or even a 5G router, and then get yourself an Ethernet cable so that your connection is going to be wired. So, because if you're going to be using Wi-Fi, then your stream won't be all that reliable. But if you go for an Ethernet cable and a 4G or a 5G router, then I promise you that you're going to get the best out of your equipment. Yeah, so that is all that you need if you are to set up a professional live broadcast and be able to stream live on the internet. So like I indicated earlier, I'm going to be doing a number of videos talking about live streaming. Of course, the first one is one that will be talking about how you can hook up the smartphone to your computer as a webcam, then use the same to stream live to either Facebook or even YouTube. And then I also do another video talking about how you can stream live using a single camera and a single capture. And of course, using more than two cameras, and that will involve the use of a video switcher like the one which is here. So ensure to subscribe to this channel for more interesting videos. Let me also mention that you need to stay safe and be protected from this COVID-19. So stay home as much as you can, and just in case you intend to go out, ensure to put on a mask and of course maintain a safe distance so as to protect yourself and other people. So until next time, this has been George Munyamumbi. And also ensure to like this on Facebook. Tech Talk Zambia is also available on Facebook. You can even subscribe to this channel on YouTube. So until next time, stay safe and be protected.